Hey MCC faculty, I wanted to give you a quick overview video on how to use Yuja in your course to create videos either of you, your screen, or both of those at the same time. So when you're in D2L in your course, you're going to go to the Yuja section. And then from there, this is where you can see videos that are already in your course, and you can manage any videos that you've already created. You can also do a video conference, but since everybody's used to WebEx, I won't cover that. But the biggest part for Yuja right now is to create a recording. So I'm going to click create a recording. And the first thing you want to know is that I'm using a Google Chrome that is fully updated. So make sure that your browser is updated. If you're on a school machine, then you need to make sure that you contact IT about getting that done. Now, if you use Firefox or Safari or whatever you might use, just make sure it's the latest version of it. If this is your first time opening Yuja, then you're going to need to download and install the software. If not, then you can click start. So I am working from home today, so I'm going to go ahead and download and install. Now, remember that if you are on your work machine at the college, when you go to install this, it's going to need the administrator username and password, so you need to contact IT. Now, when I did this at the college, there are actually two places that they need to enter their username and password, and after they did the first one, I was like, cool, I'm ready to go, and then they went away, and so I had to wait for them to come back to do it a second time, so just be aware. All right, so I'm on a Mac, so my installation looks a little bit different, but I've downloaded that. I'm going to go ahead and install it on my hard drive. And since I am at my home computer, if I remember my password, yep, I'm just going to install this software. Okay, so I'll go ahead and hit close. And then this is just something that a Mac does. So, all right, so it should be downloaded. And your computer may or may not open the software for the first time automatically. It looks like mine is not going to do that, but my computer at work did. So I'm going to go ahead and hit start here, and it's going to ask me maybe, do you want to open the application? Yes, I do. So it's going to open it on my machine, and you might need to see this is that extra password that you'll need to have IT do. Now, this is an actual application on your machine, and so you can save it to your taskbar, you can put an icon on your desktop, etc. And this is linked to your course or any courses that you have. So in the next video, we're going to cover how to actually change some of your settings, and then we will actually get to recording and changing the captions.